Good morning. Today we are going to discuss about the K3 unit chair of Austin. And if you look at the chair, it has a unique and a very viable ergonomic design for the comfort of the patient as well as the ease of doing the dental procedures with the patient. Now, if you look at the chair has all the basic features which are required or which are essential for a dental practice. A very wide tray so that all the instruments can be arranged properly. A spittoon which is a detachable. Of course, we are going to look at the more detailed features of this spittoon and the assistant management side also. In the subsequent video, the cup holder and the instrument tray for your patients belonging to QECAP, a light which has a good lux meter, and then a ergonomic design for the doctor stool for continuous surgical procedure without causing any backache for the dental surgeon.
So let's start with the doctor table. So as you can see, Austin provides a wide doctor table for surgery. So especially when a doctor needs to do a surgery, they can keep any surgical instruments. The bigger instruments can keep on this table, as well as if there are small instruments, then they can keep on this table. After that. This is the mouse pad. So if a doctor has attached a monitor, so they can access the monitor by using this mouse pad. Okay, plus this is the vest receiver where you can put a glass and you can put the vest in the glass. Like this, we can accumulate any vest in this glass.
Now if you look at the tray, doctor's tray, then the tray, if you can see here, this is a stainless steel tray which can be easily autoclave for the implant and surgical procedures or any procedures which involve use of extensive surgical instruments such as flap surgery, implant surgery. Then you have a tray which can be used for a normal surgical normal procedures, dental procedures like doing composite filling, crown cutting and etc. The special feature of this tray is the presence of a rubber mat. So what does this rubber mat do is exactly to make an anti-skid surface. So sometimes what happens if this rubber mat is not there, then the instrument can skid and fall off. So this rubber mat actually holds the instrument in the place so that doctor will not harm its expensive instruments. Okay.
So now let's start with the attachments. What are all the attachments we provide with our chair? So you can see this is the three way. So we can use a three way for air and water. Also after that we provide two air rotor handpieces which are fiber optic and which are manufactured by NSK Japan. Okay, and then this is the air motor with we provide stator and control handpieces. This is also manufactured by NSK Japan, and this is the EMS scaler with A type tip. This is manufactured by EMS.
Now, once we have looked at the trays of the particular chair and we have looked at the instrument attached over this chair, one of the beautiful things about this chair is the electronic control panel. If you look at the electronic control panel, the major portion of the electronic, the one-third portion of this panel is occupied by the LCD display. The LCD display has a white light, so which is very pleasant to the eye, which can be viewed from all the angles. So if I view from the side angles also, I will be able to see the display. So you can see in the video actually, you can see the display from the sides as well. And this panel is actually very helpful when the doctor is using this buttons on the panel. You can see all the displays over here, whatever this, it's graphically showed on this panel. For example, if you look at the left hand side instrument of this panel, you have a certain joystick over here. You have a power on and off switch on the panel. Then you have three pre-fitted modes on this chair. So, and then you have three modes which can be customized as per the dental surgeon's requirement. So let us, for example, if I use a joystick for taking the chair up, it is waiting. Now you can see as the chair is going up. Now you can see in the video also, if I'm taking the backrest down, you can see the backrest going down as well as the motion over here. You can see on the display panel also. If I take the backrest in an upright position, you can see it shows upright. If I take the chair down, again it will show the chair going down, which is also shown on the display panel. So in all, whatever you do with the chair, it is visible on this LCD screen. So very helpful. Then the next one is about the pre-threaded programs over here. This is the rinse position, gargle position. This is the rinse or gargle position. Okay. Now since the chair, let me take the chair down first. And this is a patient is into recline position, and when I press this rinse or gargle position, the reclining, it comes to a gargle position itself. The patient can take the glass of water and then gargle and rinse it off. Okay, this is a position which is at the operating rest position, and then a position which is at the ground level or the base zero position. Once the treatment is finished for the patient. Okay, now this is the position where when you are done with the patient or when the patient wants to climb onto the chair, this position you can use. Then we have M1, M2 and M3, the three modes which can be customized as per the dental surgeon's requirement. I'll try and in this frame I'll try and save one M1 position over here. So let me get my chair to a desired position. Okay, this is how normally I use it, and let us recline the back. Just for example, if I'm doing a implant surgical case, this is the position I prefer. And now I want to save this position, so I'll just press M1 and long press it. So this goes into the memory. Okay, now I'll again press this M1 and so memory safe. So my M1 is going to be this current position which has been stored into the memory for a particular dental procedures. Now for example, if I have changed the position and if I just press M1, the chair will again go back to its original position automatically. So now we are going to look at the accessory panel buttons over here, and the first button which we are going to encounter is the light switch, and you can see here the light is on, and if I just click on this button, the light has been turned off, so everything has been given over here. And the next button which you can encounter is for the water which goes to your fiber optic handpiece. So the disappearance of the yellow color actually shows that the water has not been flowing into the handpiece, and when I just click on this button again, the yellow color has reappeared, so that means the handpiece now gets the water. The second one, the third button which you can see here is the light button. So if I just click this button, now the fiber optic handpiece has light has been disabled. If I again just press it, again the yellow light glows up. That means the fiber optic handpiece is now ready to use with the light connections. Now these four buttons, 1, 2, 3, 4, are for the micromotor handpiece and to control their RPM. This button is actually for the mode controlling for the reverse and the forward modes, and then the RPM 1, 2, 3. The next button over on this side is there are certain procedures we would like to do, like composite restoration. Or there are some procedures like doing GIC restorations or laminates and veneers. When we actually stick laminates to the patient's teeth, we have to wait for some time. So here we have a button which can actually help us set a timer for this particular job, and especially when doing a light curing for composite restorations. Okay. The knob over here, and it shows a scalar button over here. This is for the vibration of the ultrasonic scalar tips. And in case if the patient has a very hard calculus, a hardened calcified calculus, so you can use this higher mode for the very difficult calculus to remove, or interdental calculus. And then if you have something anterior, we can use this at a very lower mode. Now we have come to the assistant side of the chair, and in case this chair is for the right-handed dentist, in case if you want to get the chair for the okay, now we are looking at the assistant side table over here. There is some small table which has been given to keep any assistant's instrument, or if any tissue paper roll has to be kept over here, or any cause piece or anything which can be used in during the dental procedures. Then we have a panel over here. Before going on to the panel, let us see this particular instruments. We have a high section over here, high back section for any surgical procedures. We have a 2-way syringe over here, and then we have a low section as well. Coming on to the buttons of the panel, here we can see the buttons are almost similar to the main panel at the dentist panel. These buttons are placed as per the frequency which are used for the surgical for the patients. Now if you look at this button, the button talks about the rinse position. So if you just click this button, the chair will go into the rinse position or a gargle position. Then the second button is the return button, the position in which the doctor was actually performing the dental procedures, and then this is the rest position where the chair will again go back to its own position at the rest. The last two buttons are actually for the water level. Now this button is for the filling of the glass. Here you can see the glass has been filled in case if you want some extra water. Or else another feature of this chair is the automatic filling up of the glass. If you just keep the glass over there, it automatically uses its sensor function and fills up the glass up to a certain level. The next button which we can see over here is the spittoon function. If I just click this function, or if I just keep on pressing this, you can see the spittoon has been rinsed over here, and then you just release it so that the water will be drained off. Again, there is a joystick or a control panel over here for the adjustment of the positions of the chair.
Okay, so let's start with the spittoon section. So as already discussed, this is a automatic system, a spittoon system, where you will find a sensor at the back. So if you pick up a glass and a patient pick up the glass for gargling part, and again if we keep that glass in the spittoon, so it will automatically fill that glass to a desired level, and then it will rinse also. So that you can see it is automatically doing the rinse of the spittoon glass. Also, our spittoon system is a completely detachable system. So as discussed, our spittoon system is completely detachable. So you can remove everything for cleaning purpose. So you just see, we can remove each by each part completely, and then we can completely remove the spittoon glass as well, and then you can clean this complete spittoon system on a daily basis. So as you must have seen a different chairs where the spittoon is completely fixed, so you cannot remove the spittoon glasses or the spittoon bowl and you cannot clean it. But in our system, we can completely remove the spittoon, and then again we can attach it as well, like this way. Now you can see the booster bottle connections over here. So as you can see, there are two connections. This is for the on-off button for water bottle. This is to control the pressure inside the bottle, and then this is for water supply. Means if you want water from the bottle or the city line, you can select as per your consideration. So you just see there's a gauge also there, so we can maintain the pressure according to the gauge, so that you know there won't be any overpressure in the booster bottle. And this water can be used for our handpieces. Now we will see the foot controller. As you can see, there is a joystick. There are two buttons, and also we can use the paddle for operating the handpieces. So this joystick we can completely take chair up and down by this joystick. Also the backrest we can take up and down by using the joystick. Also we have given two buttons, this is the gargling position and this is the return position. So we have to press it two times so that the chair will change its position. For example, if a doctor is operating the chair and by mistakely this button has been pressed, so the chair should not change its position. That's why this button has been given two time pressing, so that it won't change the position by mistakely. Also this foot paddle can be used to operate the handpieces while doing the surgery or any dental procedures. This is the all-in-one console where you will get a glass holder plus these two tables, where on this table we can keep the patient's belongings, and here we can keep the tissue paper so that there will be no reduce of space. Also we have provided a monitor arm, so that in future if a doctor wants to attach a monitor, so they can attach it on this side and it can be moved anywhere according to doctor's concern.
Now this monitor arm, which can be a monitor which can be attached on this particular arm, and it's kind of a swivel arm, so that you can actually change the position and show it to the patient, show to the patient's relative, and or doctor can in fact himself or see, or the assistant doctor if any, he can or she can also see it. One of the additional features of this is that when ostomy is going to get its own intraoral camera snap, and that is where you can connect the snap to the panel, and then you can have the display of the intraoral camera on this monitor. So it's going to be a value add function on this particular thing.
Now we will see the LED light which is provided in the Ostom K3 chair. So as you can see, the light is they have used a reflector for the light purpose, and the light shape is into a rectangular shape, where more of the chairs uses light shape into circular shape. So here you can see a rectangular shape for the light. Also
so the basic function of this rectangular light is like a CBCD's field of vision. So you can see over here the light is in a rectangular shape, and this rectangular shape can actually mimic the presence of the mouth. So if you can see my hand over here, so this can cover the entire mouth, or you can see that it is 15 by 9 which can be covered. So if the entire space or the entire area where the surgical field is there, it's get properly illuminated, and the white light actually gives a soothing feeling to the patient as well as dentist. And since dentists are working long hours looking into the patient's mouth, the yellow light can be a stressful light, so white light actually reduces that stress. Now one of the unique feature of this particular light of the chair is that if you can look, there is a slider over here and you can actually slide this, and the color of the light changes. Now this particular feature is very important when you are doing composite restorations. And since this is a blue light, you can see here, this is a blue light. Now this light can cause, sometimes this light can cause the Hasten curing, or the curing of the composite becomes a little faster. And before the doctor gets any chance to do a composite restoration, then the light can cure the composite. So solution for this is that we can just light this particular panel, and the color of the light changes to a yellow light, and this yellow light is the light which will not cure any composite prematurely. So therefore it is mostly used by doing a composite aesthetic composite restorations.
So as you have seen the advantages of this K3 chair light, so there is a knob to control the intensity of the light. So as you can see over here, we can control the intensity of the light. So this knob is used to control the intensity of the light. Also, currently in our new model chairs, there is a sensor over here. So if you just wave your hand, though, that sensor will turn on and off the light. So basically, and also we have from 0 to 35,000 lux intensity of the light. So it is quite a higher side intensity for a particular chair light.
So now we are going to look at the most important thing, the throne of any dentist, on which to sit for very long hours. So if you can look at here, one of the most important or the basic thing which has been taught in our dental schools and colleges is that the base of your foot should be parallel and your thigh should be parallel to the ground, so that the backache will not happen. So therefore the chair of Austin is very ergonomically designed. You can see here it provides me proper lumbar support and also lower back support. So in case if I want to just stretch it out, the chair has that ability to actually help you ease your back a bit while doing continuously long surgical procedures. Then you have a knob over here. This knob is used for adjustment of the height of the chair as per the doctor's requirement. To increase the height of the chair or to increase the length height, what you can do is that you have to just get up and then press it. So the height of the chair has gone up now. In case if I want to make the chair a little bit down and make it a parallel, I have to just give it a slight push so that the chair will now get parallel. In case if you want to go down a bit, still you can just put it, this is the final position where the chair will go. So it helps to have a proper ergonomic design and also to enhance the body posture of a dentist while working.